Greetings, Eric Bakker, the naturopath from New Zealand, where we're currently going into spring and I'm happy. Now, let's talk about autoimmune paleo, autoimmunity in general, and, you know, particularly leaky gut. Found this great page on Medscape the other day. It was 24th October, 5 days ago. Despite growing recognition that leaky gut triggers many illnesses, including autoimmunity, there is surprisingly little science on how to staunch this leak. Although restoring healthy gut and microbiota is considered a key function, conventional medical doctors debate how best to achieve this. Even unconventional doctors, whose solution is the AIP diet, the autoimmune paleo diet. So, over 450 publications have now been released on intestinal permeability. Over 450. When I started practice a long time ago and I talked about intestinal permeability, people were looking at me like I needed a psychiatric evaluation, okay? Well, no longer are they looking at me like that. Now they think I'm a real cuckoo, okay, because I've got this channel. Now, the point I'm making here is a lot of doctors know that intestinal permeability exists, but they ain't got the tools or the knowledge on how to deal with it, because many MDs, bless their souls, have used pharmaceutical medications for so long. And with all their medical training, they've had no understanding on actually how to mitigate these symptoms, on how to improve the gut apart from surgery or drugs. And they pay a lot of lip service to diet, you know. Many of them now sort of masquerade as like naturopaths, you know. There are certain types of doctors around walking around, with white coats on and saying, don't eat this food and don't eat that food. But what really annoys the heck out of me is a lot of these guys for years were prescribing antibiotics, you know. And then all of a sudden they become peacemakers, you know, they put the guns away and the bullets get put away and they start doing other kind of stuff. But that's not on to me. I've never been in that position myself. I've always worked with intestinal permeability and tried to get patients to understand that lifestyle and diet are paramount in improving gut function, not taking drugs, okay? Drugs are definitely required, but in extremely rare cases is a pharmaceutical required for a human being, right? Now, if we look at people like Amy Myers, for example, who a lot of you folks out there will know, incredible Amy Myers. Now, Amy, being a medical doctor herself, started to see the limitations, you know, the limitations of her clinical practice and started to embrace these kinds of methods. So what really annoys me is for us, conventional GPs who've gone over to the other side, I mean, it's almost like it's heaven and hell, isn't it? So what they're saying here is basically doctors really haven't got the skill set or the tools to understand how to deal with it. So, of course, then many become ignorant and say that there's no scientific proof of all these kinds of things existing. But more and more people are now looking at quite strict exclusive diets and actually getting really good results by reducing antibody titers, antibody levels, by taking gluten out of the diet, you know, alcohol, you know, all sorts of things, coffee, tea, nuts, grains, legumes, nightshades, a whole lot. I am not a fan of a whole list of, say, all of these have to go out of the diet. The physician needs to individualize this approach with the patient and not look at a cookie cutter protocol. Patients can usually start putting a lot of these foods back in relatively quick. But to me, the meat in the sandwich is not so much the gluten issue, it's how much gluten people are eating and how shitty this food really is. I'm horrified when I go to Los Angeles to see how much crap people eat. Is it any wonder they get gut problems? Crowding, stress, noisy, polluted environments, you know, huge amounts of stress, and then you throw some crappy food in on top of that. You know, it's absolutely hideous. It's no wonder people are getting autoimmune disease. Autoimmunity can be reversed. It can be stopped, particularly in the early stages before a lot of pathological destruction occurs. But when you've got full-blown Hashimoto's, it can be very difficult with very high antibody, you know, levels to turn the ship around. It's no different from a 60,000-ton tanker coming into port and you're trying to stop it on a dime about, you know, 100 yards before the port. It ain't going to happen, okay? But if you started making those corrections about 20 miles out in sea and started making tiny rudder changes and backed off the throttle, that thing would cruise beautifully into harbour. Humans are no different. Make the change back here, for goodness sakes. Don't make the change here when when the dung hits the fan. That's when it's the wrong time to make the change. And that's unfortunate for many people who don't pick up autoimmunity until they're very sick. So what am I trying to say here? Attacking autoimmunity through the gut, folly or science? Well, it ain't folly anymore. It's science, because we have Dr. Fasano, we've got Zonulin studies. We know leaky gut exists. It's time for doctors to start pulling their head out of the wine bottle and understand they need to work more with patients and individually, without medications, if they can, without antibiotics, without anti-inflammatories, all these drugs, but to look more at the pro-therapies, you know, probiotics. It makes more sense to me, and I think it does to a lot of you viewers out there as well. But conventional doctors still remain skeptical. While the pharmaceutical industry is, you know, the biggest industry on the planet, there'll always be skepticism about anything that flies into the face of a shareholder. So that's my take on it. Stay with me. I'm going to talk a lot more about autoimmunity coming up, on how you can do a lot to reverse autoimmunity. And if you can't reverse it, put a freeze on it, okay? Because it is possible. I've seen this with hundreds of patients. And just like Amy Myers, you know, I'm convinced that eating the right, you know, kind of food, living the right kind of lifestyle is the key to stop getting autoimmunity in the first place. Thanks for tuning in, as usual. Click on the link below and you'll get a free report from me. Thank you.